Namaste friends. Today I shall share with you all various varieties of breakfast recipes using ragi flour. These recipes are so easy to make, highly healthy and super delicious. We can either use plain or sprouted finger millet flour or ragi flour. So first take the splitted black gram dal. Just rinse it once and soak with sufficient amount of water for 4 to 5 hours. Once they are completely soaked, after 4 to 5 hours, we'll just grind them using the same soaked water, or we can add even additional plain water when required. To this finely ground batter, we shall now add 3 times ragi flour. So the proportion is 1 part of black gram urad dal and 3 parts of ragi flour. After adding the flour, just give it a pulse and all the flour will nicely get mixed with the batter. Add little additional water from top to make the batter and flour mix well. And here you see the consistency of the batter. Collect the batter into a vessel and nicely mix with hand. This helps to develop the good bacteria that are needed for our body grow in this batter. Just close the lid and allow the batter to ferment for at least 7 to 8 hours. Mix the required amount of water and you can either make idli, dosa, sweet or spicy kind of paniyarams, or we call as guntha ponganalu. Just add salt for a plain version of dosa and just enjoy any way you want. Here is the plain dosa. Just take an iron pan and apply some oil. Sprinkle some water and spread the batter on this pan in circles and give it a dosa shape. Then add little oil over this dosa and close the lid. After just 3 to 4 minutes, as the dosa turns brownish in color, we can open the lid and just lift it. It very easily lifts and it is really crispy and tasty. To turn it into sweet dosa, just grind bananas and then add jaggery syrup or palm jaggery syrup. If you don't have that, you may also add jaggery powder. Then add the fresh grated coconut. I usually keep it ready in a box like this. Mix the banana mixture into the ragi batter that is ready. The paniyarams or guntha ponganalu comes so good. Just add ghee into all the holes, pour the batter and close the lid. Keep the flame low and cook for 3 to 5 minutes. They also lift very easily and they are so delicious. We can sprinkle some nuts and raisins for additional taste. The paniyarams made with banana might feel little sticky and mushy from within. So you may avoid banana in that case if you don't like that taste. And just add jaggery, fresh coconut and cardamom powder to the ragi batter. The same batter can be turned into sweet dosa as well. This also lifts very easily and it's so yummy and delicious. Just pour the batter on a well-greased pan with ghee and spread it around in circles. Sprinkle some nuts and raisins and just close the lid. Open the lid and carefully lift the dosa and flip it. And your delicious dosa would be ready. Just sprinkle little more ghee and flip it. You can enjoy these dosas and paniyarams, guntha ponganalu with any sweet or spicy side dish. Actually, even the idlis turn out to be very good, but they will taste like ragi idli. Please don't compare their taste with rice idli and get disappointed. So enjoy so many different varieties with just one basic batter. I'm sure your whole family would enjoy them, and especially kids will love them, and this makes mother's job most easy in the busy mornings. Let us all connect and unify naturally, learn many new ways of making our lifestyle natural, help ourselves, our environment, and the whole future generations. Thank you so much.